Praise the Lord. We're reaching the nations for the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
We just want to say good morning to each and every one of you and take the time to say thank you for being faithful to tune in.
Yes.
You know, it's important for us to meet you every morning that we get to meet you. It is a blessing of the Lord. Amen. So without further ado, let's go to the throne. Heavenly Father, Lord, we praise
you.
Lord, we are grateful for who you are and what you're doing. We ask, God, that you would glorify yourself in all things. Now, Lord, have your way as you minister to us and through us. In Jesus' name, we pray, Lord, that you would take this word and empower the people and encourage the people to move forward in you. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Well, today we're going to begin to talk about the skill to be still and let God begin to take us through the trilogistic aspect of that. Amen. So go with me to Acts, the first chapter, fourth verse. And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which he saith, ye have heard of me. Right? He said, wait for the promise of the Father. Now, I want to say this. The church at its birth was the church at its best. Oh, I know that there are some that might challenge that because they think about the 21st century, how we can do church, if you will, through all of the social media, or how we have all of this extra technology, how we have satellites in the air and this and that and the other. But I still say the church at its birth is the church at its best, because what you fail to look at most of the time is that the church at its birth, they were more dedicated and committed to following the instruction, following the leading of the Lord.
Yes.
I'm not saying they were perfect, because just ask Ananias and Sapphira, right? But just as you can ask Ananias and Sapphira, what happened to them? Because the church at its birth was the church at its best.
Amen.
Because guess what? God is calling us to be what he wants to be the best that we can be in him.
Amen.
Amen? Now listen to this. I want you to think about this. Because though it was the church at its best, what made them that way? Because we have all of this technology, all of this stuff, and all of these agendas and things that we're doing for God, or we're doing, and a lot of them, we're doing them not because he told us to, but just because we want to.
Exactly.
But the church at its birth had the empowerment, had the power of the God, had the empowerment of the Holy Ghost. And it was the Holy Ghost, if you will, that began to drive us forward, right? And so we need to understand that the Lord is bringing us to the place that we begin to learn to be still.
Amen.
And if we're going to learn to be still, we understand that we purposely must be still, or we must purposely stand still.
Come on.
We must patiently sit still. We must position ourselves to be still.
Amen.
And it is in the stillness, you know, because the church, Jesus told them, he said, wait for the promise.
Come on.
He didn't say just run off and do what you want to do. He said, wait for the promise.
Amen.
And what was the promise? The power of the Holy Ghost. It was the Holy Ghost that caused them to move forward and to be what he called them to be.
Amen. So it takes skill to be still. And in Exodus 14 and 13, it said, and Moses said unto the people, fear ye not, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. You know, when God says stand still, he was given an order. And that stillness means to continue in the vein of pressing toward the Lord, but just don't move ahead of him. Sometimes we get ahead of God in what we want to do. God shares something with you and you take off running and it's not time. He shared it with you for you to pray about, for you to prepare for, you to get ready. You need to just stand still in that vein and soak up all that God has for us. And so he doesn't want us to get ahead of him. You know, standing still, it means that we're supposed to wait on God purposely. We're supposed to wait on him on purpose. Wait to hear what he has to say. Wait to get the instructions. Wait till we see the hand of God move in a situation before we step out on our own. Because there's a lot of things that we're doing that are just good things, and we're doing them because It's a way to keep things going and doing things, but we just have to stop and listen and stand still and see what God is saying about the matter. You know, it's even like this pandemic. You know, we need to stop.
Yes.
And stand still.
Uh-huh.
And listen to what God is saying. Amen. We hear what everybody else is saying, but what is God saying about the matter? You know, if we just do what we're supposed to do, listen, stay at home, wear your mask, do what we're supposed to do. Just stand still and watch what God does on our behalf. You know, we just need to stand still and press in to the things that God is telling us. You know, because sometimes we put ourselves, it's like the children of Israel, they've got put between a rock and a hard place. You know, God wants us to stand still and listen. He is giving instruction.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and while you're standing still, you need to understand this, that God has our back. God is standing there. He is waiting to deal with any situation, any circumstance, any emergency, anything that we could have. If we just stand still and listen to God, He won't let us down.
Now, you know, the reality is this. When he's talking about standing still, sometimes it's the issue is that we're in the way of God, and God is saying, if you just be still, then I'll work on your behalf.
That's
if you
right.
be still, then I'll deliver you. Just like the children of Israel, they were fretting when they got up next to the Red Sea, and they were crying out, and the Lord said, stand still and know and see the salvation of the Lord. And so once Moses could stand still, then he knew how to direct the people.
That's
once
right.
he could stand still, then he knew the direction that the Lord was going to deliver them.
Well, you know, and standing still takes us to be patient, and it takes strength. You have to have strength. You have to be strong in the word. You need to be patient. Standing still is not always easy. It's kind of like taking a little child. I know if I took one of the boys and I said, sit here and don't move, you know, it wouldn't be 3 seconds and we'd be up and turning flips and upside down. And we've got to learn how to sit and be still before God.
That's it.
So that he can speak to our hearts. Amen.
It comes down to, can you trust and obey? Is your faith and your hope in him?
Amen.
Or is your faith and hope in what you can do with these?
Amen.
Or what you can do with this? Because guess what? Standing still catapults us long beyond what these and this can do.
Can take us.
Because God's way is higher than our ways.
Yes, it is. And we will see you tomorrow at 7:47. Have a blessed day.